First of all, Joel Meyerowitz is a big hero of mine. That book, Cape Light, I got in the 80s. I still have it. Sometimes I still look at it. I love it. And his daughter, Arielle, is somebody that my son knows. Getting back to what you were saying that he said about being an art director as opposed to doing your own work, that's exactly it. And the hard thing is that when you first start making your own work, because really to be an artist is to leave it open-ended. And the hardest thing for me was to stop thinking about what I wanted it to look like at the end, because that was the point of the illustration. And so it's a very different mindset. And it was very hard for me at the beginning. When I was in grad school, I was still doing illustration work because I needed to make money. And it was really hard for me to switch back and forth. And I remember that after I got my degree and I was living in Greenpoint, I think at that point. And we had a group of women who visited each other's studios every month and would do critiques of each other's work and kind of supported each other and stuff. And they pointed that out to me time and again, like, you have to let go of what you want this to look like and let the process take its course. Now, that's true to an extent, but you can also sort of have a point of view of like, I sort of want it to do this. And then you have to embrace all of the stuff that happens on the way. What, Bob Ross used to call happy accidents actually is true. Something happens, like particularly when I do my cut newspaper pieces, there is one decision after another. Even though I start with a matrix of something I'm doing, I start with the pattern and I work out from the photograph on the front page. But each time I'm thinking about what's happening on the edges, I'm thinking about what I'm leaving behind and what I'm cutting away. I'm constantly lifting the newspaper, to sort of see what I'm doing. And sometimes I cut something and I go, oh my God, that was a big mistake. And then I have to figure out, how am I going to work that into the final result? And painters can paint over what they do. My process is completely unforgiving. So I have to really allow those mistakes to either I'm going to make it work and it actually will come out better sometimes, or I'll say, you know what? This one ain't working, and let it go. So that is very, very hard to do. But I'll tell you, being an illustrator, and I did work for Lord & Taylor for years. That really was how I bought my house in Connecticut and everything. It was a great job. And they were the only ones to use illustration instead of photography. They had a very signature look. I even said that in the ad. When they switched to photography, that was like the end for me, because that was such a big client of mine. So it was partially the universe telling me that it was time for me to, even though I was older, it was time for me to let the illustration go. But it was a great time in my life.